Right now, we have a very special guest. This is my good friend, David Rosenthal. All right. David is Billy Joel's musical director and keyboardist. So let me introduce David by telling you his life story.
Wait a minute, where'd you get these pictures?
Now, what is this? This is a Moog?
It's a Moog. I think it's a Series 15. It was my first synth that I ever got my paws on, and I was addicted immediately at age 15.
15 years old with a Moog modular. It's a good start, okay? So we go up a couple of years, and now we're talking Ritchie Blackmore's Rainbow. We're looking at two mini Moogs, a Hammond B3, an OBX.
OBXA.
OBXA, a Roland string machine, all right? And then we see a progression of technology as well as haircuts. Tell us what's in the second picture there, David.
The clavinet in the first one, too. Yep. In the second one, on my left there on the top, the second mini Moog was replaced by a memory Moog because it had polyphony and you could save patches. And the other spot there is an emulator one. And then, of course, the rest of it is still the same as things began to evolve, but still no MIDI. We could save some patches on some synths, and we could play chords on some synths at this point. But still no MIDI yet.
All right, and then we move up to 1986. The haircut is evolving. Tell us a little bit about, we still see the EMU in there.
Yeah, this is an emulator 2 now at this point, but this was the beginning of using a dedicated controller. This is the first time the Yamaha KX76, and if you could see behind my legs there a little bit, there's a rack of modules, and this was the beginning of that era of carrying lots and lots of different modules to get all your different sounds from. So now MIDI is in its early phases, but I dove in deep, as I usually do.
And so, I think you're playing with the Cyndi Lauper band here.
Cyndi Lauper's True Colors Tour.
True Colors Tour.
Yeah.
Now we move it up to 1989, and this is with Robert Palmer.
Yeah. Yep. So a scaled down version of it, but at this point the rack is off stage, and this is the beginning of the time where we used to started going with cleaner stages, less gear on stage, and more stuff off stage. So that's from that tour. Robert, the Simply Irresistible, the Heavy Nova tour.
Gotcha.
It was.
Yeah. Now, how long have you been with Billy at this point?
24 years.
24 years. So We went from the mullet to the ponytail, and then up to, I think this is one of the more recent rigs.
It's a few rigs ago still, but this is, again, all the stuff. At this point, I had a big, giant double rack with all the kinds of modules to recreate Billy's music that spans 30 years and uses all different types of synths. Still using synths on the stage, though, at this point. And then after this, I eventually went into using all controllers on the stage. And nowadays, everything is solid state drives and Thunderbolt. I'm using two Mac Pros. Everything lives in main stage, and all the keyboards on the stage are controllers.
And David is using a MOTU ultralight audio interface. I believe you use those on stage also?
Absolutely. I have four of them, two for each of my systems that I run.
So this is actually apropos to MOTU, what David's doing over
and
here.
And the MIDI Express XT, too.
MIDI Express XT.
I'm currently working on a side project that I'm doing with Billy. I'm correcting his entire sheet music catalog, a giant task. I've finished 5 records so far: Piano Man, Turnstiles, Innocent Man, I forgot which ones, The Stranger, and I just finished Stormfront. I'm going to go through the whole catalog, but one of the perks of doing this is I've been really transcribing all of his really signature piano parts, which are so cool, and so I don't normally play these parts, but I figured it would be cool for the NAMM show to play some of Billy's parts. I put together a little medley of a few items here.
Thank you.
David Rosenthal, everybody.